you're feeling fine. Shake my body, under a bad sun. Blue moon in your eyes, so sing it now. Load of other things ain't been the same since the blues walked in our town. Put you one in a million, cause you got that shotgun shine. Shake my body, bone under a bad sun. Blue moon in your eyes, yeah.
So it looks like the Lemons and the Young family will actually have some closure in the death behind Jamison Lemons that was missing since May the 7th of 2017. If you ever seen that video that I reported on Jamison Lemons, I'll put that video in the link in the description box so you can check that video out. I won't repeat the things that I said in that video, but pretty much Effingham police have arrested 27-year-old Justin Jammison of Lanier White Road. He has been arrested and charged with murder and concealing a death. Jamison Lemons, like I said, was missing since May the 7th of 2017. And they actually, what happened was, a month after he was missing, in the month of June of 2017, the Sheriff's Office and Metro Police executed a search warrant at 167 Lanier White Road in Clio, Georgia, and discovered burned and dismembered human remains. This month, the Sheriff's Office was notified that the DNA testing was positive, that the DNA testing was confirmed match in the DNA for Jamison Lemons. So it took them just about a year to confirm the identity and the DNA that matched up with Jamison Lemons, because I don't know how bad the body was burnt and decayed, but I assume that it was, well, his body was decayed for some time. And like I said, when your body is burnt, it decays even faster. And Jamison was actually arrested on Thursday, Justin Jamison, he was actually arrested on Thursday, May the 3rd, and he was taken and booked into Effingham County Jail. Now, I was really trying to wait on doing this type of video because when I found out, not exactly when I found out, but I waited probably like towards the end of the day, I got in contact with Jamison Lemon's mother, Miss Jamie Young. And I really wanted to get in contact with her and so she can just tell her side of the story. But that same day, they had a candlelight vigil. That was actually yesterday. And I was just waiting just to see if I could possibly interview her. But she had the candlelight vigil at the last minute, so I didn't get a chance to interview her. But more than likely, I'll try to do that hopefully this week, you know, because there's still a lot of things that needs to be said, especially from her family and from her point of view. And I just hope that this is the answer that the Lemons and the Young family is looking for. And if there's any other updates about this case, I'll let y'all know as well. But, you know, it's a real tragic situation, especially the fact that Mother's Day is pretty much this coming up Sunday. I'm pretty sure she's satisfied that she has closure, but in the same time, you know, Mother's Day is pretty much this coming up week, this coming up Sunday, and to find out that your son has been dead for a while and that they just found out around this time is just, it's really heartbreaking. My prayers go out to Miss Young, and hopefully we can make that interview happen.